Hi everybody. Today I was going to talk about the Aroon indicator, which is this indicator right here. It looks a little bit complicated, but we're going to go through all the details. And I was very surprised, coming from using the MACD and RSI and money, various types of money flow index, or even just simple price oscillators and volume oscillators, that how helpful the Aroon oscillator is. Basically the meaning of it has to do with dawn's early light. And what I was most happy with was that the calculation for the Aroon is very simple and very straightforward. We'll go into that maybe in some detail, but in general, the concept here is that if you make a new high or a new low within a time frame specified by the Aroon indicator, so here I have a 15 period time frame, so that's 15 candles back. If it's a high, if it's a new high for 15 candles, it will go automatically to 100%. If it's not quite a new high, it will go slightly below that, and that will be the Aroon value. So there's basically two types of Aroon arrows. There's an Aroon up and Aroon down. So this is the Aroon up, which I have specified in green and red. And you can specify that any color you want, and you can do any period you want for the Aroon. And it's so simple. So in 15 periods, did you see a new high for the Aroon up or the Aroon down? So if you did, it would automatically be at 100%, and that's why it goes to 100%. Otherwise, it's 0% if you never saw a new high within those last cycles. So that gives you an idea of trend. So if you think about it, for this particular instance, there wasn't a new low for quite some period of time. So, and this was the new low right here. So basically, you know, this indicator really helps out a lot. Spotting new trend reversals and also just the general shape of a trend, right? So you can see from here, this is the SPY, S&P 500, and you can see that basically the trend is definitely positive here. Now, back in here, you can see it's kind of a mixed trend. And as a result, when you have no trend for either of them, it goes down to 0%, right? So if it's not a new high for the either indicator, for the up or the down Aroon, then it would be lower on these things. So, but you can see it's slightly more green, and then the green drops down again to here, because you can see the green arrows go down here. So, but anyway, there's another Aroon called the Aroon Oscillator, and that is basically the summation of the Aroon up and Aroon down. So what I did, if you look at this here, is I specified a period of 8, and then I did a period of 15, or I could have done 16 for the regular Aroon. And that's because I want to see, was there a new high or low within 8 periods, which is basically half of the other ones, or low. So that way I can use two different Aroons to kind of monitor two different periods, so kind of like a short cycle and a long cycle. And that kind of helps me out a little bit understanding what's going on with the trend. So in general, you can see that there's a major uptrend here because it's almost at 100% the whole time. And then it drops down here pretty quickly. So the nice part about these is that, see how quickly it goes to 100%, is that on the same candle, it will often give you the new 100% level. So because of that, it's what most of the indicators are, lagging indicators. So you can see here that there was a downtrend, but it doesn't really show up super clearly on any of these other indicators. Kind of shows up a little bit here, but it's 100% from basically 0% all the way up to 100%. I think that's not quite 0%, but 0% is like down here. That was like 10%. So basically, that has to do with the levels of the Aroon and the fact that it is a leading indicator. So basically, we talked about the up This is the up Aroon, and this is the down Aroon, the red line. Anytime there's a new low, the new low will show up as a new red line. So, and you basically, most people use, you can use any number you want. But what I did, so for example, if you have the MACD on here, you can compare the MACD to your Aroon and say, if you like, where it's swapping over. So for example, the MACD, you can see that the MACD crosses over here, but the Aroon does not, right? But this particular Aroon, because it's 8 cycles, does cross over. So it starts to drop in that candle there. So it's a little bit tricky to match it up, but it's really to tell you when there's a major trend or a start of a new trend that's been very different from what you have seen. Again, it means dawn's early light. It's to help you identify trends and trend reversals and some other details. So let me go in here and show you how this indicator would work in detail. So basically, here we have basically all these other indicators that I'm using. So I'm going to close these out, simplify it just to these two Aroons, and I'm even going to use this one for a little bit too. So, but basically what happens here, so let's compare it to the MACD and see how accurate it is, right? So basically, on this particular tick, so this was the high right here, right? And you can see that the Aroon already starts to detect that new downtrend, whereas the MACD doesn't really detect it. It just flattens off a little bit. So you can see the downtrend shows up a little bit more on the Aroon just right here. And you can see this little spike here shows up and this little spike here shows up, indicating that there is some pressure on the downward side. Whereas this hasn't, MACD hasn't even crossed yet for its indication. However, if you use the MACD properly, it is possible to start using it and saying, hey, these little trends, even though it hasn't crossed yet, you can kind of anticipate it crossing ahead of time. So both are pretty good and very helpful. So here's a quick comparison to the Aroon with the RSI. So you can see here, this trend and the same trend, right? You can see that it's really saying this is an uptrend. It's easy to see that it's an uptrend using the Aroon indicator because it says all the way up pretty much at 100%. Whereas the RSI pretty much tells you that it's still on its way up at 50%. So you know that using this Aroon that you can tell that it's for sure an uptrend. Whereas sometimes with the RSI, you can say, hey, this is like 50%. Or something like that in that range, and maybe it's not necessarily an uptrend. And that's basically could be true. That's why you need multiple indicators, because this is coming out of a midpoint here, but the Aroon detects it really early on because it says, hey, this is a new high. excuse me, a new high out of the range of 15. So that's why of these 15 cycles, you can tell that it's going to get out of a range. So basically it's telling you that it's kind of like a range indicator in some ways, because what happens is that for those 15 cycles, it wasn't this high. Once it got to here, it instantly detected it and said, hey, we're out of that range. We might think about this as a possibility for a new trend heading up. And indeed it was correct on that perspective. Now you can see that there's a little bit of a downtrend here, but it was still in the 100% range. So because it had the 100%, that means it's still, even though it could have dropped below a little bit that candle, you can see this candle here and this one here, it's still, the Aroon is still at 100% almost. So that still tells you that it's part of the uptrend, and it would have to make a new low within these previous 15 candles in order to actually really start to have the Aroon down to be correct, right? So again, you can see that it doesn't really tell us what the trend is. It just says here, it says at 49, but then this Aroon is saying we're gonna have a definite downtrend. And it says on the oscillator as well. So I just want to try a different time frame here on a shorter time frame, minute per minute time frame, and show you how this works as well. So the big money winner for the day would have been if you would have gotten in here and sticked with this for that whole time, right? So the Aroon says right here that it's a high indicator, right? So it's hard because this is, has a swap in it. So this is one of the most difficult times for the Aroon to detect. And you can see that if you're trading this right in this range, you could say it just came out of a high and you don't really know what's gonna happen yet. But what happens is that when the Aroon gets this candle, it says definitely you gotta be in it for the downtrend, right? And even though there's a little bit of an uptrend here, it said this left this whole part of this thing, and now this, even this part uptrend, downtrend, the Aroon is saying definitely get involved in a downtrend. And in fact, it's really correct, right? So you can see that there's one little part up in here where the Aroon is maybe, it still says it's part of a downtrend, but it's starting to be, when they both go to 0% or they both cross, that's maybe a crossing point, and you don't necessarily know what is gonna be high or low. So the, again, it goes back to a downtrend here, and you can see the downtrend, and then it kind of picks up. Again, so right in here, you can see the downtrend is starting to drop again, so you could get out of the trade if you needed. But in general, you can see on this part, when it's the first downtrend of the day, it detects it really quickly, and you can see right there on this, actually on this candle, it detected it, right? So on this candle here, on the 8 pattern, it detected it. You can see right there, it started to drop, and it's below 0, and it started to drop even more. And then by this candle, it's at 100% certain that it's a downtrend. So you could have gotten in on this whole candle here, certainly. So when I'm doing normal trading, I'll use a lot of other indicators. So the Aroon is just one part of that whole flow. But in general, I like to use the MACD. So you can see here, kind of prioritizing the MACD pretty highly. And then the volume oscillator as well, very highly. And I use those two and then kind of use this to tell me what the trend is in addition to that. So if I see a new trend showing up from the Aroon indicator, I know that I really need to maybe put in extra position, or basically, because it's probably a serious new trend, a new low in this case, you can see here, right? So basically, I'm going to change these around a little bit. So I'm going to put an 8, we'll show you an 8 on this and what it looks like. So it kind of sharpens up certain ones of these a little here, makes it a little bit tighter within the last 8 candles. And then I'm also going to change this one to 16. I had the other one at 15. And then it gives it a little bit more detail in here. So now we have two different types of runes going on. Now the stochastic one, you can say it works similarly. It's also, it's pretty accurate on these. You have to zoom in, we can zoom in on this chart, and you can see that this is hard trading in here, because a lot of that, some of that is leveling off. The main point is that if you're interested in the rune, it would be helpful to have the Aroon oscillator too, just to kind of compare it at first when you're first using it. I found it very helpful because it's basically the subtraction of these two. If we put the same numbers in here and you take the Aroon, this one minus this one, you can get the output being this value for the Aroon. So basically this would be a negative, this is a negative Aroon, so you got basically 0 down in here. But you can see it did catch the main trend of the day, which is very important. So that's kind of how I would use this and say that, you know, maybe it's not going to catch everything for you exactly the way you want. I mean, certainly if you study the details in infinite detail, it would catch everything. But it's really hard to understand all the details. So basically, the most important thing to me was that it caught the one of the biggest trends of the day. And then that also was caught, you can see, by the MACD. And was not really caught by the volume oscillator. You can see that the volume oscillator here showed that there was still some positive volume kind of sneaking in here. It was negative, it's below this line, so the volume is negative. So in that sense, it did catch it. Basically the big trend of the day, all of these indicators pretty much caught them. But the nice part is, if you look at which indicator catches it first, you can start to say, okay, aha, this indicator right here might have been better. It looks like stochastic momentum index. And that's just the basic reason why you want to use many different indicators. Anyway, so this was a pretty interesting discussion. I hope that there's just a lot to go through. I would say I might even do a follow-up discussion on how the rune works in more detail, but I just wanted to get to an overview. For sure, what I would say is make sure that you understand how the calculation works for the rune. If you understand that, you're really going to be confident in when you use it. And that's kind of what really sparked, my interest on this. Anyway, thanks for listening, and let me know if you have any questions. Please like the this and also subscribe, and I'll try to get back to you if you send me a message. Thanks a lot.